Dear 24, 8:55 a.m. Most of the housemates are in the bedroom. Ian and Jermaine are in the kitchen. Tonight, Cleo, Dirk, Ian, Joe and Shilpa will face the public vote. Housemates are unaware that tonight will be a double eviction. Jermaine is talking about his wife.
I can't wait to see Halima.
Oh
my God.
It's nice. It'll just make it even better when you see her.
I'm never leaving her like this again, ever.
Good.
Never. Never.
But it just
confirms. Do you see my face lights up?
Not long now. It's weird because I feel, I was saying last night, I feel like I've got one foot outside the door and one foot in.
Mm-hmm.
I'm there.
That door's gonna open tonight.
Yeah, for somebody. It's strange because I really want to go, but I'm so close to the end as well. I'm like, oh, I really want to stay and I really want to go. I feel like I've not failed in any way,
mm-hmm.
You know, and I've loved my time here. So if it was my turn to go tonight, it would be good.
Mm-hmm.
But equally, it would be good to stay as well, because I can just see the finishing post, just in the distance. So it'd be nice to just kind of ride it out a little bit longer.
I'm never gonna forget this house, though. I'm probably gonna have like dreams of like
nightmares.
Being in here, then all of a sudden I wake up and I'm at home, because this is definitely put a mark on me.
Mm-hmm.
I've never done anything like this.
I'm never again.
This is very different.
No. I've never done anything like this, and I don't think I would do it again.
Nine thirty a.m. Ian has been jogging in the garden for 14 minutes. Cleo and Jermaine are at the dining table.
What makes you angry?
When people are not nice and they're just deliberately trying to make you upset. Mm.
Shilpa is in the bathroom. The rest of the housemates are in bed.
Execution day. people are gathering here. The clock's ticking.
Nine fifty-one AM. Shilpa and Jermaine are in the kitchen.
Well, tell me how much you're having. You're having this? Do you keep the bigger courgettes for everybody else?
Tell me, are you cooking for them? Because look,
I will be.
I'll take this.
Okay.
Are you cooking for them?
Yeah, there's enough broccoli, there's enough vegetables.
See, you gotta stop cooking for them and just cook for yourself.
But that's so mean now.
Hey. Do you get a thank you when you prepare it? Do you?
I don't look for a thank you.
No, but do they? Not that you look for, but are they appreciative enough to say thank you?
Yeah, they do say thank you.
Joe, Danielle, Dirk, and Jack are in the bedroom.
Are you going to eat your salmon today, Dirk?
Yeah, my leftover salmon. Ooh, look at me.
That made you really happy last night, didn't it?
Yeah, didn't it?
Morning, Dirk.
Good morning.
Did you have a good sleep?
Pretty good. Pretty good.
So after all that fish?
I had a dream. It was so bizarre.
Uh-oh.
Scorpion people.
Scorpion? Oh, my God.
I was out of Big Brother. A Big Brother person took me to this university, like in Manchester somewhere. We walk down this really beautiful bar. There's this guy standing in black suits with slicked black hair straight back. And they turn and they have black faces and noses like beaks. And beautiful suits, white shirts and ties. They turn and look at me like, you don't belong here. And this guy, there's like three of them. The whole bar is only full of these
people. These people. Guys.
Well, he says, that's right. I said, what kind of people are there? They're obviously immigrants. I mean, they're not native to England. He said, those are scorpion people. Those are scorpion people. Immediately, this other scorpion guy, who's in a beige suit and is actually a maitre, was one of the, works for this bar thing. He grabs me very firmly by the arm, and he grabs this other guy. I say, are you throwing us out? And I say, I can't believe you're throwing us out of here. He just nods like that, and they push us out. So now we're out in the lobby. And I turn around, and the university guy's gone, and I see him down there. He is so mad. He's trying to find people to say what's happened. And I woke up.
That obviously means that's where the scorpion people and where you
outside.
Think
the scorpion people are outside.
Outside?
I think I'm going to be stoned when I go out.
No, I don't think
the scorpion
so
people.
I don't think so.
Maybe scorpion people are Big Brother. And they're... And
I think you're going to
throw me
like
out.
You there.
Oh, man. I don't know.
10:32 AM. Most of the housemates are in the kitchen.
Could you reach
look
that?
A mess.
Yeah, wicked.
Oh, man.
Thank you, Dirk.
You knew how to get there.
I do play that when I have sex, but other than that, I don't
have much information.
Not while I'm having my breakfast, please.
No, because it's fun.
Do you have sex? I'm not talking about with yourself.
Nervous, like. Oh, yeah.
What is that, Dirk? Are you frying the skin?
I just fried up the skin.
That's just gorgeous. Oh, yeah.
That salmon stinks. That's going to make me vomit.
Oh, damn, because that might make that.
Yeah. That stinks. That should have been thrown out last night. That is fucking revolting. That fish smell is coming in here. Oh.
You're not outside for a stogie? Then bring it on, baby. Crack. You'll be here, Jack. You and Jermaine and Danielle.
Some, you might be.
Till the end. I might be. I have no idea how this is being perceived. That's why when you go out, you have such an unfair advantage. You don't know what you're walking into. This is the opposite of reality TV. This is just a really cheap corporate way to try and create a TV show. It's got nothing to do with reality or real people or anything. It's just this way you don't need to find some guy with genius and imagination that can actually write a frickin' show. Just get a bunch of numbskulls that'll go live together, and it's like monkeys on a typewriter. Put 1,000 of them in a room for 5 years, and maybe you'll come up with a play. It's totally, it's what children can do when they're 8 years old without even thinking. It's got nothing to do with what Jermaine does for a living. It's so far removed, it's not even in the same. And then they call it reality TV. And one guy like Leo Sayer shows up and you gotta kill him. Because they won't succumb. They won't play the game. They just won't play the game. So the less you do, Jermaine's got it nailed. Just sit quietly in a corner, wait for it to be over, and then go back. Which I have tried to do. But it's not my real personality, so.
...10:50 a.m. Dirk and Jermaine are in the kitchen.
Ian, are you having some of this?
Please, oh yeah, I will.
Yeah.
Got a few bits to do and then I will dive in, if that's all right.
It's got a little bit of fish taste to it.
That's all right.
I fried the tofu in the same
fish.
Oil.
Ooh, yeah. Nice.
I kind of like it.
Have you seen how many stock cubes are here? And we had that huge argument over two of them the other day.
Was that oh yeah, I remember that.
Two cubes. Vegetable cubes.
Chicken cubes. Sir.
Two chicken cubes, and now we have 300 chicken cubes.
Danielle, Joe, and Cleo are nowhere.
Oh, Dirk's looking at us. No, we don't want any fucking fried fish.
Fish skin as well.
Fishy skin. He's cooking it up for everyone, and he's like, yeah, I'm cooking fried. Skin's up for everybody. And then he's like, fucking, oh, nobody else wants to eat it. I'll have to eat it all myself.
Ugh, I went fancy eating fish skin.
It's nice out here. Why didn't we do this earlier?
We moved to the lounge, then the fish
followed. Yeah, I'm not very in the mood for smelling fish when I just woke up.
No. Yeah, you've got a little chumminess going on now, haven't you?
Did you hear them this morning? Yeah, I often have sex to this song.
It was the 18th theme tune.
And
I tell you what, no, I bet he probably would have known.
No, not
if he's put down the person he admires most is himself.
That was a bit of a shocker, I have to say.
If the person he admires the most is himself, you can bet your bollocks he's
shocked
his own song.
Exactly. Oh my God, the dirty bastard.
Well, he's allowed to have sex, isn't he?
No.
Well, not to the theme tune, at least.
I don't want... Well, I don't even want to know whether anyone else is having sex or not. I don't want to know. That is revolting.
Ugh. 11:50 a.m. Dirk is in the garden. Joe is in the diary room.
With the eviction happening later this evening, how are you generally feeling?
I'm feeling nervous. I've got no idea what it's going to be like out there. That's the bit I'm nervous of. I don't know how people have reacted to me since I've been in. Are we going to walk out to people cheering or walk out to people booing? You just don't know how you've been perceived. So it's just all apprehension. Is that the right word? Yeah.
Danielle, Jack, Ian and Shilpa are at the dining table.
Have you had any Hollywood movie stars chat you up or anything?
Arnold.
Arnold?
Recently.
Did he? He's got a wife.
We got along really well with Lionel Richie.
He's a lovely guy. We did duets with Lionel.
He came all the way to Goa for a friend's 50th birthday. Mm. And I saved him from the crowd. So I was his knight in shining armour.
You know, it's really strange being gay in this industry and other people keeping it quiet as well.
Is Lionel gay?
No.
Is Arnold gay?
No, but there were people like me that wanted, you know, to stay, you know, keep it personal and keep it quiet.
Yeah, I guess. I guess being a celebrity is hard enough. You'll be fine. You've dealt with it very, very well.
Yeah.
I think this was a good thing that you did.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm really proud of, you know, who I am now.
I'm proud of you. How does it matter what the world thinks about you as long as your family and your friends support you?
Oh, absolutely.
The rest shouldn't matter.
I'm really happy. I really am.
You're just wondering how people would react to you, because that's the first time you would be out there.
No, you know, I'm a trustworthy guy, but if people who are gay but keep it quiet in the business, I would never say. But, you know, there are some major superstars.
Mm-hmm.
And that's their business, you know.
I don't see the problem in coming out and saying you're gay, but people...
No, but I know of a lot of people, like huge stars, pop stars in Britain, that have asked me out.
Really?
Oh, yeah. But I've always had a partner, so I wouldn't anyway.
No. 1:42 p.m. Shilpa is in the diary room.
I think I've had the most wonderful time in here. It's given me the opportunity to, you know, to know so much more that I wouldn't have known. I always thought people would have a different opinion about me because I'm Indian. Before I got into the house, I thought it would be difficult for me to bond with them. But I think I've done just fine. And I've done good. And we all have the same color blood running in our veins. And we all share the same emotions. And it's very easy to make friends.
Jermaine, Joe, Cleo and Danielle are in the kitchen.
Like a cup of anything?
Mm.
Would you like a cup of anything, sweet pea?
I think so. I think I need one.
You do?
Yes, thank you.
What would you like?
I'll have tea as well, Pete. Oh, my God, Jan.
Sorry?
What's the matter? I'm just scared.
What did you say?
Have you had a lick of sugar? What's the matter? I'm scared. Don't be scared. Get some sugar in, so you feel better.
Hey.
Look, it's nearly all
do you want something
there
to cry about? Look in the mirror and look at the... If you had that reflection...
Oh, you know we love you.
Do you want a bit of chocolate with
hazelnuts
in?
You know
you're
there,
babe. Hmm?
I don't want us to go.
We don't want to go, too. We're trying to be funny
jokey,
but we want to stay with you, but...
Do you know what?
It's the game, you know?
Tonight, you'll be pissed. Right? And you'll fall into bed and you won't even think. And then tomorrow, you'll get up and you might be a little bit lonely, but... You'll be going home tomorrow.
And you won't have any tasks, probably, for three or four of you to do. I don't know how many of us might be staying. I mean, maybe we won't all go. Maybe two of us will stay.
Mm. Might not even go yet.
So what do you want? A cup of tea with some sugar?
Yes.
Yeah? A cup of tea with some sugar?
Okay.
I'll make a really magic-y one.
Don't panic. Yeah.
Ian and Dirk are in the garden.
Yeah, it's pretty easy to predict who's going to win this.
Who do you think?
Well, for me, the most amazing person here is Danielle, because she has no, what's the word, she has no...
Inhibitions?
Totally, none. She's just completely and totally herself every moment.
She is,
everybody
but...
else protects themselves at certain times.
Of course.
Everybody else hides themselves a little bit or protects or shuts down. She, I've never, she, for 24 days, has been Danielle.
Absolutely, but
she wears herself on her sleeve.
But what worried me slightly was the way that Jade influenced her. That worried me, and Danielle didn't do herself any favours.
But that's who she is. She's
yeah, she's just very young.
Protection,
but,
yeah.
But if she does, then, you know, she deserves it as well.
I'd kind of like to see Shilpa win. I'd like to see a non-Brit win. Cool. Has that ever happened?
Is that you?
Yeah, some of us foreigners. Take it home to America. Oh, that'd be so cool. Actually, if I did, it'd be kind of cool.
You imagine. Oh, so it's cool now you win.
They go...
That old crony?
How did you do that? You always irritate people. They thought maybe if they did
it becomes
this.
Endearing after a while.
Right. They finally saw through me.
That
I finally figured you
that
out.
Cute old man inside.
Yeah. Waiting to get out.
Yeah.
Four 12 PM. Jermaine, Ian and Shilpa are in the lounge.
I'm hungry now.
Jack and Danielle are in the kitchen.
See, that voice, I can't handle that much longer.
Wow.
That squeaky voice she always does, that's amazing.
You're not going anywhere, Shilpa.
Never be too sure, sweetheart. Never be too sure.
That is true.
She's got to stay and make some more vegetables.
Do you like cooking, Jermaine, or you just can't
cook?
Yeah, But you stand over her and watch her cook.
Be sure she's doing it right.
Yeah, can you imagine?
And it's still not right.
Cleo is in the diary room.
I think I've reached a limit here, and I love all the people who will be potentially staying, but I'm really ready to go home. I'm so ready to go home.
You said that you're ready to go home. Do you think you will be going home tonight?
Yes, I do. I do. In my gut, I feel it. Not only think it, but in my gut I feel it. So I hope I'm right, because I hope I haven't been distorted in here.
Have you enjoyed your time in the Big Brother house?
I have. Sort of. I have. I feel very, very, very exposed in here. And I know that's obviously what it's about, but it feels a bit creepy with all the cameras the whole time. I don't know what people have seen or how I'm going to be judged and what reaction. But then that's the thing, is that'll be real, because people have actually been watching us.
5:08 PM. Dirk, Jack and Ian are in the garden.
This is Big Brother. Would Ian ensure his microphone is switched on at all times?
I turned it off, sorry, because I went to the toilet.
Not only do I not turn mine off, I hold it in the bowl. I put it between my legs in the bowl so that they don't miss anything, if it's that important.
Are you serious?
I have done.
You're a dirty fucker.
Joe and Cleo are in the lounge.
We'll be fine.
Oh, I don't think I've ever been awful.
No.
I haven't said awful things.
Well, apart from a few things. Listen, let's just get through it how we usually do.
Yeah.
You know, with a bad joke and a laugh. I know that I'm getting nervous.
I'm getting my rash.
Don't scratch.
Do you think you'll be stoned to get up?
Probably, yeah. Well, you. It's all right. It don't matter if you get stoned. You won't get through that, yeah.
Do you think people are going to... They will, won't they? I think so. You won't. Everyone likes you because you're so funny.
I'm going home tonight.
I'm going because I've been really awful.
No, you haven't.
I have.
You ain't, Clay.
I have.
Honestly, you ain't.
I have. own beds tonight, missus.
And then tomorrow we'd have to meet up and...
Yeah, and go through it all. Yeah. But, yeah, no, be on the phone. We'd like, say we got home at midnight, I'd be on the phone, 12:15.
Yeah, no, do.
Hello, love.
Oh, wouldn't that be good?
Just the one phone up, you know, just for a chin wag.
I don't think Ian will go.
No, I don't think
Ian will go. I think he'll stay. And I think Shilpa'll stay.
Mm. I do too.
And I think Dirk will stay because he's played the game really well.
Yeah.
I don't mean that maliciously. I just mean, he's dealt.
Yeah. I think it's me and you.
I do.
Gut instinct. I think maybe we're going home tonight.
Seven 36 PM. Most of the housemates are in the lounge. On eviction night, Big Brother plays crowd noise into the Big Brother house to drown out the sound of the live audience.
They asked me. They asked you about your biggest revelations and things. They asked me, and I said you were one of them.
Really?
Well, because when I go out there, I'm going to champion you so much. You're the one person who I didn't think I would.
Yeah.
After a point, I suddenly knew you were playing games. You were having a laugh, and I took it seriously. So for that, I apologize. Yeah. But I'm going to champion you so hard when I get out here.
Well, I
realize that. It's become a bigger circle with you for me. And I want to tell
I've been in trouble before for joking and teasing. But usually that's why I always got along with British people. When I did Broadway play, they were always very...
Yeah, but you know what? I think
way.
In here we all feel a different pressure.
And
I just think if you're still here, I know you're only here for a couple of days, I still want to take you and your son to that bar I told you about. You have a great time. But that's what it's all about, isn't it, this place? Stretching your elastic.
Yeah.
Mm. I champion you because you taught me a big lesson here. Not to believe
you.
Primarily, I thought, wow, where was I when this was going on?
Yeah.
I thought you hated me. I did.
Well, I thought you really hated me.
You looked at me one day like you could kill me, I thought. But now I'm going to go out there and champion
you so hard. Why would
you
think that?
Because you're horrible.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
I made more fun of Leo than anybody.
Yeah, but he jumped over the wall. So he... Look what happened to him.
No, he immediately laughed.
He kicked the door down, Donnie jumped over the wall.
He immediately laughed.
But he left.
That wasn't me. That was underwear.
Oh, dear.
Yeah.
Oh, Doc, you're a revelation, I have to say.
Yeah.
9:22 PM. Big Brother has gathered all the housemates for the results of this week's public vote.
Four people.
The fourth person.
Joe!
Shit.
It's good.
It's great. Get Joe out.
Right, so far.
Yes, they was.
What?
Didn't you hear it?
They love you.
Ignore it.
And
me.
Who's coming with me?
Me.
Oh, please, my God.
We're going to be
The fifth person to be evicted from the Big Brother house is...
What's your name?
Oh, God.
Cleo.
Told you.
We knew it.
Yeah, I know. I knew that.
Okay, that's good.
I'm shaking like a leaf. Are you?
That's good. No, I'm not.
I'm shaking because I heard him saying, get Joe out.
You heard it, right?
Get Joe out.
You heard it.
Leo,
you have 30 seconds.
We're going
out to
go.
Bye.
You alright?
Just Joe, what about the three? That's it. Bye, Jermaine. I will. Come on, let's go. Guys, we'll see you Sunday. Take care. Bye, Jermaine. Rocket, Keel, come on. I will. I'm so happy.
Just two.
Two are gonna leave tomorrow.
Huh?
Oh. Are you terrified?
No.
They're being really bad.
Don't stop it. Who cares? We're not bad people. Your fans are there. Listen. It's fine. They don't boo us.
It's good news.
They cheered.
Right.
Come here, lovely. You're right.
Maybe we can go to bed now. Or maybe there's more. Maybe there's more. There might be more. So there's still... What's wrong with Danielle? Right? What's wrong with Danielle? She's fine.
And we're going to be in here. We're going to look after you, all right? You're going to have to cheers.
I heard my mother was hanging out about the child.
You don't know anything.
Get Joe out.
Don't know anything. I didn't hear that.
It's okay, see, the five fingers, all of them are different, right?
If it was that bad, they wouldn't have let her out.
Exactly.
But Joan.
She's fine. And she's right. Happier. Right. She's happier out there.
If it was that bad, they wouldn't have let her out.
That's true.
She was the one that surprised me on there. Getting so emotional over it. I was a little shocked. I predicted Joe. I said it would be first Joe, second Cleo, third me.
What coke?
Should have gone over, I think.
Oh, yeah. Jake, you okay?
You all right?
I am. I'm okay. Huh?
Still here.
I'm still here. But there's going to be more, right?
Can you imagine?
Gotta be more.
And don't get affected by the booze. Just don't.
We all love you in here. Jermaine loves you. Jack is so fond of you. I love you. Ian is so fond of you. Dirk, who doesn't like anybody, likes you. See?
Mm-hmm. Mom, we are the only two girls in this house. I've seen what I have to get you now. You have to put my eyelashes on for Sunday, okay?
Okay, that's a good thing.
And you have to paint your nails, my little short nails. I thought maybe the two boys were gonna go first. I don't know what I thought. I've never thought that you were going home for 1 minute. I knew that.
I was prepared for it. Never mind. And I just find you very boring. I am boring.
Who are you?
No, you're not. You're funny. You're funny. You're funny when you don't mean to be, and you've been feeding me onions. You're the only person my mum can't even make me eat onions. My makeup a mess now.
You can never be a mess. Bloody hell, I hate you.
I hate you.
Ten o six p.m. Danielle, Ian, and Jack are in the lounge. It's been 39 minutes since Joe and Cleo were evicted from the Big Brother house.
I wasn't expecting two people to go out then. No way.
Dirk, Shilpa, and Jermaine are in the kitchen.
Joe got her wish.
She did.
She got her wish, boy. She's out of here.
And I was, right on. I'm so proud because I tell Big Brother I knew what I was talking about. I've been right all along.
I said it, I couldn't say it. Dwayne J cursed that girl out.
Yeah.
But did you see how she had to leave here? Nobody out there, people, and those choppers were flying over because it's probably a big story out there.
Yeah. You think? Yeah, that's what
that's
going
what they
down.
All felt. Yeah. I can't wait to find just to hear.
But see, I could feel that coming. I could feel that coming.
And you,
I could feel that coming.
And you notice once she left,
yeah,
everything was normal. But and she's not a bad person. She's not. Her mom's not. But they just don't mix. Certain people don't mix.
Yeah, but I don't quite understand why Shilpa. I don't quite get that. Right, I got ideas, but
it could have been like Cleo. They could have picked on. I said the same thing.
Oh, they were
why
gonna
her?
Pick on her.
Why know? Her? Because it could have been this one, that one, that one.
Yeah, she's young. She's beautiful. She's
yeah.
And you explained it all in there.
Yeah,
that was it. That was you know, it was part of it, but it had bad overtones. It had a bad.
What is Joe doing right now, you think? She's
running she's her mouth. Dog.
How many girls we lost? We lost.
First one was Jackie, then Carol, then Jade, then
these two.
Jade, four. Oh. Then Cleo and Joe, five.
Five girls we lost?
There's been no guys evicted. Is that right?
Yeah.
Donnie and Ken and Leo all left.
Yeah, they all quit. They all said,
I'm no kidding. Next time I see Leo, I say, you know, when you're in the trenches in a war, you don't run out on your comrades.
Yeah,
huh?
Man.
p.m. Jermaine and Dirk are in the garden. Jack, Ian, and Danielle are at the dining table. It's been 1 hour and 49 minutes since Joe and Cleo were evicted from the Big Brother house.
Joe and Cleo.
I'm sorry if I got upset before. It wasn't that.
Fine.
I was gutted that they went and that you's never. It wasn't not
do
like
know what?
That.
Don't even have to explain it.
It feels like my two best mates have just been ripped away from me.
Dan, you don't have to explain it because in here you don't know what to feel and why you're feeling it. It's weird. I feel completely lost.
I feel like I've known them, like, forever. And, like, we used to have a giggle and stuff, and me
but
and
Joe,
I used to talk to Joe when we were some bad for nights and
too
stuff.
Much sleeps. That's all it is. And it feels... Do you know what? It feels like a lifetime in you, because there's nothing else to do. But do you know what? Tomorrow we'll go fast. We'll probably have the tea word. I'm sorry for saying it.
Do you know what? I could think of nothing better than a task.
What, now? Do you want one now?
No. Tomorrow, to keep your mind occupied.
Cleo, when we were waiting there, she kept consoling everybody. Are you all right? Are you all right? It's because she was frazzled.
Yeah.
You know, she's projecting all this stuff on her. Are you okay? Are you okay? Everything's going to be all right. We go this. Everything's just creating people being upset. Mm-hmm. It's because she was upset.
Ian went to the restroom four times. He was so funny. He was funny.
He peed four times in 20 minutes.
It's funny.
Yeah.
When I heard them shouting, I'm going to get Joe out, I was waiting to hear them go, Danielle's a bitch or something like that. And I was just waiting to hear something.
That's what I was doing.
And then I heard Dirk's name get shouted. Mm. And that was it. That's all the names I heard.
They wouldn't have had an audience if they thought it was unsafe or it was bad.
That's just me.
But you can't judge this crowd out here, what the whole country thinks. You can't.
No, but I'm thinking, if they're thinking that about Joe, do they think that about me?
Yes, I think no.
You can't answer those questions, you can't. But I don't think so.
Joe wasn't a horrible person, though. She was nice.
Oh, it's just scary, Dan.
But just say you've just done one thing, one little thing, and then it can just change the whole perception of you. They were saying something to me today, I was sitting outside with them, and I don't think they, even though like I was their little mate and that, I don't think they let me into all their conversations all the time. Like, I think they had like their own little things between themselves.
You know, don't take that personally, you know, it's just they had their own little thing going.
Yeah, I know. No, I'm not bothered anyway. I'm made up, I'm still here till the end, though. That's what I wanted, so I'm not going to say it's not or whatever. I'm made up. If it would have went, I would have been OK, but I'm just really happy that I'm here.
..12:29 a.m. Most of the housemates are in the bedroom.
It's going to be a much quieter house. I feel the house has changed already.
Yeah, it's a heavily changed.
It's amazing how the dynamic changes.
Yes.
When people who influence other people go, and they don't mean to do it, it's just... Some people are more dominant than others. And some people some people need to be dominated. Do you know what I mean? I've seen a different Danielle tonight. She's so lovely. And when she has a positive, surroundings, then that brings out the best in her.
Danielle is in the diary room.
How are you?
I'm sad. Very, 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 very sad. I've lost my two best friends in the house. I don't want you to get me started again because I'll start crying.
How did you feel when you heard Joe and Cleo's names announced?
Well, when Davina come on... me and Joe both thought that we could hear, get Joe out, get Joe out. And then I just looked at Joe and I didn't want to say anything in case she hadn't heard it. And then she said, can you hear that? And then I thought, I wouldn't want to walk out to that. That's just wrong. It's really, really... It's just got me... I don't know, it's just horrible. It's really, really horrible.
Danielle, how does it feel to still be in the Big Brother house?
I never wanted to go home. I've enjoyed the experience and I'm glad that I'm going to be here. Well, hopefully, till the end.
How are you feeling about the prospect of leaving the Big Brother house?
To be honest, if you really want me to be honest, I'm absolutely shitting myself. Absolutely shit myself. I've never been up for eviction before, so I don't know how the public perception of me is. I hope I haven't done anything horrible in the house, or, you know, I don't think I have. So I hope people like me, and I don't know. It is a scary thing, though, having to walk out and see people again. I think on Sunday I'll probably feel sick. I am nervous about leaving. But I'm going to have to, so I'll have to deal with it.
You are now voting for the housemate you want to win, Celebrity Big Brother. Who wins? You decide. Call 090 11 32 33, followed by 03 for Danielle, or 04 for Dirk, or 06 for Ian, or 07 for Jack, 10 for Jermaine, 14 for Shilpa, or text the name of the housemate you want to win to 84466, and join Big Brother on Sunday at 8 p.m. when the winner will be announced live. Or in the bedroom.
It's going to be a much quieter house. I feel the house has changed already.
Yeah, it's heavily changed.
It's amazing how the dynamic changes.
Yes.
When people who influence other people go, and they don't mean to do it, it's just some people are more dominant than others.
Danielle is in the diary room.
How are you?
I'm sad. Very, 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 very sad. I've lost my two best friends in the house. I don't want you to get me started again because I'll start crying.
How did you feel when you heard Joe and Cleo's names announced?
Well, when Davina come on, me and Joe both thought that we could hear, get Joe out, get Joe out. And then I just looked at Joe and I didn't want to say anything in case she hadn't heard it. And then she said, can you hear that? And then I thought, I wouldn't want to walk out to that. That's just wrong. It's really, really... It's just got me... I don't know, it's just horrible. It's really, really horrible.
Danielle, how does it feel to still be in the Big Brother house?
I never wanted to go home. I've enjoyed the experience and I'm glad that I'm going to be here. Well, hopefully, till the end.
How are you feeling about the prospect of leaving the Big Brother house?
To be honest, if you really want me to be honest, I'm absolutely shitting myself. Absolutely shitting myself. I've never been up for eviction before, so I don't know how the public perception of me is. I hope I haven't done anything horrible in the house, or, you know, I don't think I have. So I hope people like me and... I don't know... It is a scary thing now, having to walk out and see people again. I think on some.
The rest of the housemates are in bed.
Shut up, fucking thing. What is going on?
introducing day. People are going here. The clock's ticking.
a.m. Shilpa and Jermaine are in the kitchen.
Well, tell me how much you're having. You're having this? Do you keep the bigger courgettes for everybody else?
Tell me, are you cooking for them? Because look,
I will be.
I'll take this.
Okay.
Are you cooking for them?
Yeah, there's enough broccoli, there's enough vegetables.
See, you gotta stop cooking for them and just cook for yourself.
But that's so mean now.
Hey. Do you get a thank you when you prepare it? Do you?
I don't look for a thank you.
No, but do they? Not that you look for, but are they appreciative enough to say thank you?
Yeah, they do say thank you.
Joe, Danielle, Dirk, and Jack are in the bedroom.
Are you going to eat your salmon today, Dirk?
Yeah, my leftover salmon. Ooh, look at me.
That made you really happy, that.
The dining table.
Have you had any Hollywood movie stars chat you up or anything?
Arnold.
Arnold?
Recently.
Did he? He's got a wife.
We got along really well with Lionel Richie.
He's a lovely guy. We did duets with Lionel.
He came all the way to Goa for a friend's 50th birthday. Mm-hmm. And I saved him from the crowd. So I was his knight in shining armour.
You know, it's really strange being gay in this industry and other people keeping it quiet as well.
Is Lionel gay?
No.
Is Arnold gay?
No, but there were people like me that wanted to, you know, to stay, you know, keep it personal and keep it quiet.
Yeah, I guess. I guess being a celebrity is hard enough. You'll be fine. You've dealt with it very, very well.
Yeah.
I think this was a good thing that you did.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm really proud of, you know, who I am now.
I'm proud of you. How does it matter what the world thinks about you as long as your family and your friends support you?
Oh, absolutely.
The rest shouldn't matter.
I'm really happy. I really am.
You're just wondering how people would react to you because that's the first time you would be out there.
No, you know, I'm a trustworthy guy, but if people who are gay but keep it quiet in the business, I would never say. But, you know, there are some major superstars.
Mm-hmm.
And that's their business, you know.
I don't see the problem in coming out and saying you're gay, but people...
No, but I know of a lot of people, like huge stars, you, pop stars in Britain, that have asked me out.
Really?
Oh, yeah. But I've always had a partner, so I wouldn't anyway.
Oh. 1:42 p.m. Shilpa is in the diary room.
I think I've had the most wonderful time in here. It's given me the opportunity to, you know, to know so much more that I wouldn't have known. I always thought people would have a different opinion about me because I'm Indian. Before I got into the house, I thought it would be difficult for me to bond with them, but I think I've done just fine and I've done good. And we all have the same color blood running in our veins, and we all share the same emotions, and yeah, it's very easy to make friends.
Jermaine, Joe, Cleo and Danielle are in the kitchen.
Like a cup of anything?
Would you like...
A.M. Dirk and Jermaine are in the kitchen.
Ian, are you having some of this?
Please, oh yeah, I will.
Yeah.
Got a few bits to do and then I will dive in, if that's all right.
It's got a little bit of fish taste to it.
That's all right.
I fried the tofu.
In
same
the
oil.
Ooh, nice.
I kind of like it.
Have you seen how many stock cubes are here? And we had that huge argument over two of them the other day.
Was that like two? Oh, yeah, I remember that. Cubes.
Two cubes. Vegetable cubes.
Chicken cubes. Right?
Two chicken cubes, and now we have 300 chicken cubes.
Danielle, Joe and Cleo are nowhere.
Oh, Dick's looking at us. No, we don't want any fucking fried fish.
Fish skin as well.
Fishy it's just skin. He's cooking it up for everyone and he's like, yeah, I'm cooking fried skins up for everybody. And then he's like, fucking, oh, nobody else wants to eat it. I'll have to eat it all myself.
I wouldn't fancy eating fish skin.
It's nice out here. Why didn't we do this earlier?
We moved to the lounge, then the fish
followed. Yeah, I'm not very in the mood for smelling fish when I just woke up.
Yeah, you and Doug have got a little chumminess going on now, haven't you?
Did you hear them this morning? Yeah, I often have sex to this song.
It's the 18 theme tune.
And
I tell you what, no, I bet he probably wouldn't know.
No, I'm not.
If he's put down the person he admires the most is himself.
That was a bit of a shocker, I have to say.
If the person he admires the most is himself, yeah, you can bet your bullets he's
his
own song.
Exactly. Oh, my God, the dirty bastard.
Well, he's allowed to have sex, isn't he?
No.
Well, not to the theme tune, at least.
I don't want... I don't even want to know whether anyone else is having sex or not. I don't want to know. That is revolting. Ugh.
11:50 a.m. Dirk is in the garden. Joe is in the diary room.
With the eviction happening later this evening, how are you generally feeling?
I'm feeling nervous. I've got no idea what it's going to be like out there. That's the bit I'm nervous of. I don't know how people have reacted to me since I've been in. Are we going to walk out to people cheering or walk out to people booing? You just don't know how you've been perceived. So it's just all apprehension. Is that the right word? Yeah.
Yeah, I'm really proud of, you know, who I am now.
I'm proud of you. How does it matter what the world thinks about you as long as your family and your friends support you?
Oh, absolutely.
The rest shouldn't matter.
I'm really happy. I really am.
You're just wondering how people would react to you because that's the first time you would be out there.
No, you know, I'm a trustworthy guy, but if people who are gay but keep it quiet in the business, I would never say. But, you know, there are some major superstars.
Mm-hmm.
And that's their business, you know.
I don't see the problem in coming out and saying you're gay, but people...
No, but I know of a lot of people, like huge stars, you, pop stars in Britain, that have asked me out.
Really?
Oh, yeah. But I've always had a partner, so I wouldn't anyway.
Oh. 1:42 p.m. Shilpa is in the diary room.
I think I've had the most wonderful time in here. It's given me the opportunity to, you know, to know so much more that I wouldn't have known. I always thought people would have a different opinion about me because I'm Indian. Before I got into the house, I thought it would be difficult for me to bond with them. But I think I've done just fine. And I've done good. And we all have the same color blood running in our veins. And we all share the same emotions. And... yeah, it's very easy to make friends.
Jermaine, Joe, Cleo and Danielle are in the kitchen.
Like a cup of anything?
Mm.
Would you like a cup of anything, sweet pea?
I think so. I think I need one.
You do?
Yes, thank you.
What would you like?
I'll have tea as well, Pete. Oh, my God, Jan.
Sorry?
Oh. What's
the
matter?
I'm just scared. What did you say?
Have you had a lack of sugar? What's the matter? Huh? I don't know. I'm scared. Don't be scared. Get some sugar into you and you'll feel better.
Hey.
Look,
it's nearly all
over. Do you want something
to cry about? Look in the mirror and look at the other. If you had that reflection.
Oh, you never would
Do you want a bit of chocolate with your
name?
Hazelnut.
No,
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 no. Hmm? We don't want to go too. We're trying to be funny and jerky, but we want to stay with you. But
you know what?
It's the game, you know?
Tonight, you'll be pissed. Right? And you'll fall into bed and you won't even think. And then tomorrow, you'll get up and you might be a little...
Thank you, Derek.
You knew how to get there.
I do play that when I have sex, but other than that, I don't
have
much information.
Not while I'm having my breakfast, please.
No, because it's fun.
Do you have sex? I'm not talking about with yourself.
Nervous today. Oh, yeah?
What is that, Dirk? Are you frying the skin?
I just fried up the skin.
That's just gorgeous. Oh, yeah.
That salmon stinks. That's going to make me vomit.
Oh, damn, because that'll make me fat. Yeah. That stinks. That should have been thrown out last night. That is fucking revolting. That fish smell is coming in here.
You're not outside for a stogie? Then bring it on, baby. Crack. You'll be here, Jack. You and Jermaine and Danielle.
Some, you might be.
Till the end. I might be. I have no idea how this is being perceived. That's why when you go out, you have such an unfair advantage. You don't know what you're walking into. This is the opposite of reality TV. This is just a really cheap corporate way to try and create a TV show. It's got nothing to do with reality or real people or anything. It's just this way you don't need to find some guy with genius and imagination that can actually write a frickin' show. Just get a bunch of numbskulls that'll go live together, and it's like monkeys on a typewriter. Put 1,000 of them in a room for 5 years and maybe you'll come up with a play. It's totally, it's what children can do when they're 8 years old without even thinking. It's got nothing to do with what Jermaine does for a living. It's so far removed, it's not even in the same. And then they call it reality TV. And one guy like Leo Sayer shows up and you got to kill him. Because they won't succumb. They won't play the game. They just won't play the game. So the less you do, Jermaine's got it nailed. Just don't do, just sit quietly in a corner. Wait for it to be over and then go back. Which I have tried to do. But it's not.
The only two girls in this house. I've seen my sister with you. Mm-hmm. You have to put my eyelashes on for Sunday, okay?
Okay, that's a good thing.
And you have to paint your nails, my little short nails. I thought maybe the two boys were gonna go first. I don't know what I thought. I've never thought that you were going home for 1 minute. I knew that.
I was prepared for it.
Never mind. And I just find you very boring. I am boring. Who, you? No, you're not talking. You're funny. You're funny when you don't mean to be and you're going to feed me onions. You're the only person my mum can't even make me eat onions. My makeup a mess now.
You can never be a mess. Bloody hell, I hate you.
I hate you.
Ten oh 6 PM. Danielle, Ian, and Jack are in the lounge. It's been 39 minutes since Joe and Cleo were evicted from the Big Brother house.
I wasn't expecting two people to go out then.
I was.
No way.
Dirk, Shilpa and Jermaine are in the kitchen.
Jo got her wish.
She did.
She got her wish, boy. She's out of here.
And
she's
watching us. I was right on. She's I'm so proud because I tell Big Brother I knew what I was talking about. I've been right all along.
I said it. I couldn't say it. DJ cursed that girl out.
Yeah.
But did you see how she had to leave here? Nobody out there. People and those choppers were flying over because it's probably a big story out there. Yeah.
You think? Yeah, that's what's going on.
Yeah. I can't wait to find just to hear.
But see, I could feel that coming. I could feel that coming.
And you,
I could feel that coming.
And you notice once she left.
Yeah.
Everything was normal, but. And she's not a bad person. She's not a bad person. She's not, her mom's not, but they just don't mix. Certain people don't mix.
Yeah, but I don't quite understand why Shilpa. I don't quite get that. Right, I mean,
yeah.
I mean, I got theories. I got ideas, but I...
It could have been, like, clear.
Anna gay?
No.
Is Anna gay?
No, but there were people like me that wanted, you know, to stay. You know, keep it personal and keep it quiet.
Yeah, I guess. I guess being a celebrity is hard enough. You'll be fine. You've dealt with it very, very well.
Yeah.
I think this was a good thing that you did.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm really proud of, you know, who I am now.
I'm proud of you. How does it matter what the world thinks about you as long as your family and your friends support you?
Oh, absolutely.
The rest shouldn't matter.
I'm really happy. I really am.
You're just wondering how people would react to you because that's the first time you would be out there.
No, you know, I'm a trustworthy guy, but if people who are gay but keep it quiet in the business, I would never say. But, you know, there are some major superstars.
Mm-hmm.
And that's their business, you know.
I don't see the problem in coming out and saying you're gay, but people...
No, but I know of a lot of people... like huge stars, you pop stars in Britain,
yeah.
That have asked me out.
Really?
Oh yeah.
It's that guy one bit, isn't it?
But I've always had a partner, so I wouldn't anyway.
Oh. 1:42 p.m. Shilpa is in the diary room.
I think I've had the most wonderful time in here. It's given me the opportunity to, you know, to know so much more that I wouldn't have known. I always thought people would have a different opinion about me because I'm Indian. Before I got into the house, I thought it would be difficult for me to bond with them, but I think I've done just fine and I've done good, and we all have the same color blood running in our veins, and we all share the same emotions, and it's very easy to make friends.
Jermaine, Joe, Cleo and Danielle are in the kitchen.
Like a cup of anything?
Mm.
Would you like a cup of anything, sweet pea?
I think so. I think I need one.
You do?
Yes, thank you.
What would you like?
I'll have tea as well, Pete. Oh my God, Jan.
Sorry?
Oh. What's the matter?
What did you say?
Have you had a lack of sugar? What's the matter? Huh?
I don't know.
I'm scared. Don't be scared. Get some sugar into you and you'll feel better.
Hey.
Look, it's nearly all
over. Do you want something to cry about? Look in the mirror and look at the... If you had that reflection...
Oh, you know. I'm sorry if I got upset before. Wasn't that like... It wasn't
Thanks,
that
fine.
I was gutted that they went and that you's never. It wasn't not
Do you know
like
what?
That.
Don't even have to explain it.
It feels like my two best mates have just been ripped away from me.
Dan, you don't have to explain it because in here you don't know what to feel and why you're feeling it. It's weird. I feel completely lost.
I feel like I've known them like forever. And like we used to have a giggle and stuff and me
but
and
you know,
I used to talk to Joe when we were in bed for nights.
Too
stuff.
Much sleeps. That's all it is. And it feels... Do you know what? It feels like a lifetime in you because there's nothing else to do. Do you know what? Tomorrow we'll go fast. We'll probably have the tea word. I'm sorry for saying it.
Do you know what? I could think of nothing better than the task.
What, now? Do you want one now?
No. Tomorrow, to keep your mind occupied.
Cleo, when we're waiting there, she kept consoling everybody. Are you all right? Are you all right? It's because she was frazzled.
Yeah.
You know, she's projecting all this stuff on her. Are you okay? Are you okay? Everything's going to be all right. We go this. Everything's just creating people being upset. Mm-hmm. It's because she was upset.
Ian went to the restroom four times. I counted four. He was funny.
He peed four times in 20 minutes.
It's funny. Yeah.
When I heard them shouting, I'm going to get Joe out, I was waiting to hear them go, Danielle's a bitch, or something like that. And I was just waiting to hear something.
That's what I was doing.
And then I heard Dirk's name get shouted. Mm. And that was it. That's all the names I heard.
They wouldn't have had an audience if they thought it was unsafe or it was bad.
That's just me.
But you can't judge this crowd out here, what the whole country thinks. You can't.
No, but I'm thinking, if they're thinking that about Joe, do they think that about me?
Yes, yeah, I think not.
You can't answer those questions, you can't. But I don't think so.
Joe wasn't a horrible person, though. She was nice.
Oh, it's just scary, Dan.
But just say you've just done one thing, one little thing, and then it can just change the whole perception of you. They were saying something to me today, I was sitting outside with them, and I don't think they, even though like I was their little mate and that, I don't think they let me into all their conversations all the time. Like, I think they had like their own little things between themselves.
You know, don't take that personally, you know, it's just they had their own little thing going.
Yeah, I know. No, I'm not bothered anyway. I'm made up, I'm still here till the end, though. That's what I wanted, so I'm not going to say it's not or whatever. I'm made up. If I would have went, I would have been okay, but I'm just really happy that I'm here.
What to cry about? Look in the mirror and look at the... If you had that reflection...
Oh, you know, we love you. Do you want a bit of chocolate with
you? You know, you
know,
Used to go.
We don't want to go too. We're trying to be funny and jokey, but we want to stay with you. But
do you know what?
It's the game, you know?
Tonight, you'll be pissed, right? And you'll fall into bed and you won't even think. And then tomorrow, you'll get up and you might be a little bit lonely, but you'll be going home tomorrow.
And you won't have any tasks, probably, for three or four of you to do. I don't know how many of us might be staying. I mean, maybe we won't all go. Maybe two of us will stay.
Mm. Might not even go yet.
What do you want? A cup of tea with some sugar?
Yes.
Yeah? A cup of tea with some sugar?
Okay. I'll make you a really magic-y one.
Don't panic. Yeah.
Ian and Dirk are in the garden.
Yeah, it's pretty easy to predict who's going to win this.
Who do you think?
Well, for me, the most amazing person here is Danielle. Because... she has no, what's the word? She has no
inhibitions?
Totally, none. She's just completely and totally herself every moment.
She is.
Everybody else protects themselves at certain times.
Of course.
Everybody else hides themselves a little bit or protects or shuts down. She, for 24 days, has been Danielle.
Absolutely. But
she wears herself on her sleeve.
But what worried me slightly was the way that Jade influenced her. That worried me, and Danielle didn't do herself any favors.
But that's who she is. She's
yeah, she's just very young.
Protection,
but,
yeah.
But if she does, then you know she deserves it as well.
I'd kind of like to see Shilpa win. I'd like to see a non-Brit win. Cool. Has that ever happened?
Is that you?
Yeah, some of us foreigners. Take it home to America. Oh, that'd be so cool. Actually, if I did, it'd be kind of cool.
You imagine? Oh, so it's cool now you win.
They go,
that old crony?
How did you do that? You always irritate people. They thought maybe if they did
it becomes
this.
Endearing after a while.
Right. They finally saw through me.
They finally figured you out. That cute old man inside.
Yeah. Waiting to get out.
Yeah.
4:12 p.m. Jermaine, Ian and Shilpa are in the lounge.
I'm hungry now.
Tweet, 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 tweet. Tweet, 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 tweet.